Hello, Bukowski Center.
Hi, I'm looking for Tita Torres.
This is her.
I am calling because there's a dog that is in my neighborhood and it's been chained for days.
The second I heard dog on a chain, it just kind of makes me pause for a second. I mean, is it in someone's yard?
It's in this abandoned lot. It's all fenced in, but the dog's been just sitting there chained up. I've seen, you know, maybe a few neighbors, like, throwing food. Like, I'm very concerned about the situation.
Okay, well, I will drive by and see what I can do. The caller said that the dog is chained up with no water or shade, and that's a deadly situation. I don't have time to free up one of my guys to go, so I'm gonna head out on my own. Oh, there he is, right there. Oh, wow. Hey, buddy. It's like 200 degrees in the sun. I'm looking around and there's no food, there's no water, there's no shade, and I've gotta get him out of there now. The best weapon ever, hot dogs. Being tethered or chained up, dogs can create what's called boundary frustration. It's just the constant wanting to get loose and get free. It can create a state of desperation from that dog. When I go on to these rescue calls, I don't go in there cocky and think I can handle any situation. I'm cautious. I mean, no one wants to get bit. Hey, buddy. You okay? I do kind of assess the situation. Was he lunging and barking, and what exactly was he telling me? Here. Oh, come on. Is it good? Yeah. Hey. Okay. I watch your hands. Hi, buddy. You know what? He saw that I was there to help him. He was friendly. Then, you know, I felt like this will be okay. I can handle this. It would have been a different situation for me if I had tossed him those hot dogs and he had just like, whoosh, nothing. Hold on. I know it's hot. I'm hot too. Hey. Once I got close enough to the dog, then I saw that I had another problem on my hand.
Oh, my good God.
The dog was padlocked to his collar and his chain.
How do people do this, you know?
We'll grab that. Hold on.
Never leave home without him.
I don't take bolt cutters because I'm here to steal someone's dog and cut down their fence, but pit bulls on chains is such a common thing. And there's been many times where we've gotten to a rescue call where the chain's actually embedded in the dog's neck. So the only way to get it off the dog is to actually cut it off the dog.
All right, let's figure this out, okay? Let's figure this out together. I did it!
Yeah. Hold on. It's one thing to pick a dog up off the street because there is the potential that it is someone's dog that got loose and they're looking for that dog. But when the neighbors called and said this dog had been chained up in this empty field, and they hadn't seen anybody, and they were the ones feeding it and giving it water.
Thank God for some nice neighbors. Hi, buddy.
It's one of those times where I have to make an executive decision, take the dog and say, yeah, there's an owner, come and get me. So now we have yet another dog coming up to Villalobos.
There we go. All right, buddy, we're almost here.
Can you meet me up at the top and bring the microchip scanner with you? Because I have this new dog here and I want to scan him and see if he has a chip. You know, microchipping a dog is kind of like doggy LoJack. When a dog comes into an animal shelter, you know, just like when you buy groceries, you know, you scan them.
Okay. Hold on there, buddy. Hold on there. Hold on there.
Ooh. Come here, silly. Come here. Relax. Okay. You want to scan or you want to hold?
Hold.
Ready? Okay, hold on. Okay, another irresponsible owner. Then again, what do I expect from a dog found tied up in a vacant lot? Like, you know, but
yeah,
gotta do the responsible thing and still check, just in case.
He's so cute. See how he got your muscles. Got your muscles. Come here, you wild beast.
Oh, jeez. Come here. Come here.
Got muscles. Oh.
What are you gonna name him?
Duck, duck, goose.
Goose is cute.
We shall call you Goose.
Our priority after making sure that Goose was, you know, healthy and not stressed out and comfortable is to get him neutered. And then, you know, we'll put him up for adoption.
Okay.
See if somebody wants to adopt a Goose.
Yeah.
All right. Good deal. Mondo and I are taking Roxy back to Cheryl, her old owner. And I'm really curious to meet her face to face and hear her story.
after what Roxy's been through, you know, Roxy has some serious issues. She's filled with anxiety. She doesn't trust anybody.
This poor dog, she's had it rough, and she's always going to be a high-maintenance dog. I don't know how it's going to play out.
Hi.
Cheryl?
Yeah.
I am too.
Hi.
Thank you
so much.
You have no idea.
This is Armando.
Hi. Hi. So
you know, Armando kind of was the one that spawned the whole rescuing of her. We just didn't know it was going to turn into such a big story and a big thing for her. Yeah. It's
like, I just thought I lost her. When I first met Roxy, I actually was addicted to heroin, and it was really hard. So that's what ended me actually in jail. Me and Roxy's connection was because she knew, like, she had that sense of that something was wrong. I definitely think that if Roxy wasn't with me during those times that I was using, things would have been way more worse. When I got out, I came straight out here into a sober living. Then I found this place, and I haven't touched it, so it's been a year now.
Really?
Yeah, since May 28th of last year.
So congratulations, that's so cool.
Yeah, so I've been doing pretty good. I'm sober, I'm renting a guest house from one of my friends. It's really a good feeling to be able to provide for her to run and play and be happy and be a dog.
You know, you can tell she has like a lot of demons, you know, inside of her, and just because of things that she's been through. She's still very guarded of her surroundings. Mm-hmm. If you were careful before, you're gonna have to be even double careful now. Even if she doesn't remember you, don't take it personal. You know, she's been through a lot.
Yeah.
So I'd like to just take her out by myself, just kind of let her walk up and down the street a little bit, just kind of like just see where she's at.
Okay.
Okay.
Yeah, we got it.
I'm nervous, I'm excited, I'm happy, I'm sad, because I like just remembering what I put Roxy through, it just makes me like, it hurts me a lot. I just thought I was gonna lose her, like I didn't know what happened to her.
No, I totally get it. And again,
it feels so bad, because like, I should have been there for her with her puppies. And
I understand, you know, things happen, life happens. I've been there, you know? So don't beat yourself up for it. You know, just know that she's back, and for a reason she's back. So let's just make it a positive, and let's grow, and she's counting on you.
She's my little partner is back.
Yeah, your partner's back, man.
Calm down. When I got Roxy out of the van, she was just yanking me everywhere and just very detached from me. Chill out, Mama. She didn't want to take treats from me. She didn't want to acknowledge that I was there. Of course, in my mind, I'm thinking, God, is Roxy going to try and bite her? You know, what's Roxy gonna do? All these things are going through my head.
Oh my God, Roxy, oh.
Oh my God. I was very nervous that Roxy wouldn't recognize me, but I had this feeling in the back of my mind, she has to remember me. Like, everything we've been through, how can she not remember me? Mama! Roxy! Mama! Mama! Hi, Mama! Hi, baby girl! Hi, Mama!
I have not seen her act like this once since we've had her.
I love her.
That is so amazing. That is amazing. I love it.